Hey guys, it's Nicole, and this is going to be a video on a failure in communication. I see this happen quite often, and it even happens with me. Let me give an example. Let's say you have a patient that is supposed to get a surgery, but it might be canceled tomorrow, but the attending wanted that patient in PO at midnight. Let's say it's about 5 a.m., you have the most recent labs, so you call the attending to confirm the surgery. You are then told that the surgery is canceled at this point due to the labs, and the patient can be put on a solid regular diet. You go into the patient's room, explain to them that they cannot eat, and give them a menu, and then you leave. This sounds like you've done all that you can do, you've done as you were instructed, but there is a huge lapse in communication there with you and the patient. You know that the attending has canceled the surgery on your end due to the labs. But the patient has no idea what's going on. All they know is they were in PO at midnight. They haven't eaten all day. You didn't allow them to take medications or sips of water. And now all of a sudden they're allowed to eat. What has changed? Now, this might not be a big deal for you, but if I'm a patient waiting on a surgery and then you walk in and tell me that I can eat, I want to know what has changed. And it's going to stress me out that you don't find that important either. As a nurse, you know, we go through our day, we do our tasks, we do our assessments, but sometimes we really have a gap in communication with our patients. Every time I round with my patient, even with hourly rounding, I want to know, is there anything that you would like me to answer for you or try to get the answer for you before your physician gets here? Because I hate being hung up on things that a nurse should know. I was in a hospital a couple of weeks ago and I wanted my labs, and the nurse told me she couldn't share those with me. I didn't really understand why, but then when my doctor came in, he told me to refer to her. The wishy-washiness, the he said, she said, is really annoying when you're in the hospital and people are claiming to be there for you and to care for you. I know logistically, maybe HIPAA-wise, she couldn't express those labs to me without my physician, but if the physician's there and the nurse is there, why can't I get my labs from one of you two? And that's kind of where I see the stressors of being a patient show themselves through. It's through failures in communication as far as procedures go, and definitely nursing care plan updates. If my surgery has been canceled, or I'm getting pain medication now, or my pain medication has been discontinued, please tell me that before I ask for it. Before I'm 10 out of 10 pain and I need it, and then you tell me I can't have it, when it's changed, why don't you tell me right then so I can brace myself for not having pain medication? And a lot of nurses tend to forget that huge gap. You might know the full story, you might have all the details, but does your patient have all the details? And I want to know if anybody else had that issue when they were in the hospital, or as a nurse, are you working on that? I'm not saying I'm perfect, I'm a nurse, it happens to me, I'm told something, I failed to reiterate that to my patients, but I am working on it. In real life, as nurses, we're very busy, but you're caring for a patient. Let them in, you know, on the inner circle of their care. It's just, it sounds crazy, but I've met people who have been in the hospital for 3 days and have no idea what they're signing consent for. I have to call a doctor and have them come and explain, but there are people in the hospital who have no idea why they're there, and that's really sad. I wanted to know what you guys thought about the subject. Do you agree? Do you disagree? Let me know. As always, if you guys have any questions or comments for me, please put them on the bottom. But once again, thank you for taking the time to watch my videos and your continued support, and have a great day, guys. Bye.